What's a bouzouki? Okay, bouzouki is a Greek instrument. We used to call it like a mandolin on steroids because it has 8 strings, but it's a really, really long neck and an egg-shaped body with a round back. If you watch any Greek movies or go to a Greek restaurant, you'll see a bouzouki.
Yeah, so if you play bouzouki, do you also play a lot of classical stuff or stuff that's more like your cultural heritage?
Yeah. I mean, when I play bouzouki, it's not rock music. I have this thing with bouzouki because of my dad. My dad passed away a few years ago, and it's kind of like a soft spot in my heart. But so I do play classic bouzouki music on bouzouki, but on the Tommy Lee record, I took the bouzouki to the studio, and I did a bouzouki solo on Tommy Land the Ride. I think the song was called Sister Mary. But it was really awesome because I got to actually record bouzouki on a rock track. And I called my dad right away. I go, "Dad, I'm recording bouzouki on a Tommy Lee song." So that was kind of cool. This is an example of a bouzouki song. All right. That's a little bit of Greek stuff for you. Yeah. I took bouzouki lessons when I was 17, and I thought, man, if I incorporate that, because with a bouzouki, there's no distortion, and the strings are doubled like a 12 string, so there's no room for error. You can't be sloppy because you'll sound like crap. So when I applied that to guitar, it just made my guitar playing give me an edge over a lot of other players. So I use that as a tool to develop. I think I knew that wasn't enough. I knew that, you know, everybody was going to be able to play Eruption, but it was only Eddie Van Halen that came up with Eruption. And he really stood out from every other guitar player because of how inventive he was. So right away, even when I was 15 when I learned it, I thought, okay, if I want to be like that, I have to be inventive. So I started coming up with different kinds of licks, different kinds of tunings, different kinds of sounds, and it totally paid off.
Segue.
Into bouzouki.
A segue for you.
Okay.
This will be great. So the Flip It Out intro is an example.
No.
Is an example of.
I can't do it.
Well, when I heard the Flip It Out intro, I thought, who thinks of that?
Yeah. Right? Yeah, me. Okay. Okay. You want me to play, don't you? Sorry. Okay, I will try. I haven't played this in a really long time, and every time I do, I botch it. But when I was 18, I mastered it.
It's
my own thing. What I did was I wanted to come up with something where I was mixing harmonics, which are like false harmonics, with actual notes. So the piece kind of goes like this. Wait, there's one more lick. So he asked when was the first time I played in front of an audience or a crowd. And my dad was nuts, right? He was a party guy. So we'd go to a Greek wedding and I was 8. And he got me up to play, like he knew the Greek band and he was like, hey, my son's, he didn't even ask. My son's gonna get up and play an Elvis Presley song. And the guy's like, oh, okay, sure. How about when we take a break? Done. And then I get up there, And they're like, so what keys is he in? He goes, no, he's playing by himself. You guys just eat, it's okay. I sang and played Blue Suede Shoes, I was 8, and there was like, maybe, it's a Greek wedding, could have been 1,000 people, I don't know. Yeah. And then after that, how old are you in grade 6?
I had 11, 12.
Okay, 11, 12, and this is when I really knew that I wanted to rock out for a living. There was a talent show, and I played guitar, and at Reese's, girls ripped my clothes off. Yeah. And that was like, this is awesome. Except I don't think awesome was a big word back then, so it was, this is great. Yeah, buddy. Where did I find the Tone Master? It is rare. Actually, there's a funny story about that too, because I can't find another one anywhere. But the Tone Master was a friend of mine, and he had that model and a 212 model of the same amp. And he didn't have enough room in his house in Chicago. And he goes, hey man, can I send you this amp? I'm like, yeah. So he sent it to me, and it ended up being like the coolest amp ever, right? So flash forward to like July. I finally met my hero, Eddie Van Halen. He came into the studio where we were recording because he heard about this amp. So from a producer that was working with him, so Eddie Van Halen walks into the studio, and he goes, hey, where's the amp I'm supposed to check out? I'm like, damn, dude, you're Eddie Van Halen. So I go, it's this Tone Master, and he goes, I got 100 of those in the garage. And I'm like, you bastard. So he's got 100 of them in a garage. But I've heard about this garage. He's got like 100 of those, 100 Plexis, 100 Twins, a whole bunch of stuff. So, but it was really cool to meet him, so. But that amp is a Tone Master from the early 60s made by Magnetone. Okay. There's a point in this song where we do a stop. And I want everybody in the house to scream out, ole. Can everybody give me an ole? Give me an ole! Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Thank you very much. You need cooling. Oh, baby, I'm not fooling. I'm gonna say, yeah. Go back to your school. We're down inside. Honey, you need love. I'm gonna give you my love. I'm gonna give you my love. Oh. Wanna hold that love, hold that love, hold that love. Here it comes. From the future to another place, a double feature you've never seen. It's a